Hi, my name is Trent.
Hi, I'm Olivia.
And hi, I'm Katie.
And we go to Louisville High School Kilo.
And this is our presentation.
As employees increasingly disregard non-compete agreements, businesses are tending to take legal action. We contend that non-compete agreements can be used as long as employees are given fair benefits and annual pay.
Now, you may all be asking, what is a non-compete agreement? Well, a non-compete agreement is a contract that you sign stating that you cannot work for specific competing businesses should your current employment end. This way, you cannot share confidential information with the other business.
Now, we invite you to watch a short video going more in depth on non-compete agreements.
What is a non-compete? A non-compete is an agreement between an employer and an employee that enforces a restriction on the employee. A former employee under a non-compete agreement could be restricted from working for competitors for a stipulated period of time. Usually, employers use non-compete agreements to protect their valuable intellectual property, such as trade secrets, customer client lists, and business practices. It's a way for employers to make sure that their valuable assets will not be made available to a competitor. State law determines when and where a non-compete agreement is enforceable. State law governing this type of agreement varies specifically among states and industries.
The pros of a non-compete agreement. A non-compete agreement is a legal tool that businesses use to keep all their secret information, their coveted information, and just maintain a competitive advantage over the other companies. This is normally given with the contract and stated ahead of time, saying that they will not be allowed to go to other companies who are competing with them or companies in a certain area.
In addition to gaining a competitive advantage, these companies using a non-compete agreement can carve out a unique identity and set itself apart from others. It can also use strategies that other companies may not be using. This can employ to the thriving success that the business already has. Using a non-compete agreement can also increase employee retention. If an employee is giving sufficient benefits for signing a non-compete clause, then they will want to stay at that business. If they stay at that business, then the employer won't have to worry about the employee working for a competing company, and they won't have to dabble into legal action.
The cons of a non-compete clause. When we start talking about the highly more sought after professionals in the profession, they may be a little bit timid when it comes to signing a non-compete clause. For them, signing a non-compete clause may be a deal breaker. They may want to have the feeling of feeling free to go and look around at other businesses if they want to. When you use non-compete clauses in the business, it may make your employees feel as though they are restricted, and thus it could lower the company's morale.
Enforcing a non-compete agreement may heighten legal liability, making employers have to take their employees to court. This may be the case, especially if you have many employees that choose to disregard the contract. This will not end well, because no business wants to have to take 35 employees to the court. But it can be very bad for the business, and it can overall make the business just flunk out and not do good things.
Enforcing a non-compete clause can lead to losses, substantial financial losses toward the company. If an employee does happen to join another business, pursuing legal action could waste money and time, and no one wants to do that. And this could overall adversely impact the overall financial stability of the business.
Here we have a graph. On the bottom here, we have how much money someone makes. And on the side here, we have the probability of signing a non-compete clause. On the lower end, we see that the less amount of money you make, the less likely you are to sign a non-compete clause. Over on the higher end, we see that the more money you make, you're more inclined to sign a non-compete clause. This is because you have greater expertise and you're given more access to the company's highly sought-after information.
Considering the scale and size of big companies, take Apple and Samsung for example, implementing a non-compete clause would be beneficial. Both companies have very big secrets that they need to keep private from prying eyes, and they need to keep their resources to themselves. If someone were to find their information and release it to the public, many other competing businesses would try to make the same products, making a big turnout in revenue that they wouldn't have made originally. This would be terrible for the big business because, one, they might be losing some clients because maybe the other companies are selling their products for cheaper, but also their secrets, and it would take years and years of work, effort, and resources to refix the damage that has been done for the company's revenue. However, non-compete agreements don't have to apply to big companies like Apple or Samsung. They could apply to companies like a pediatrics office or a hairstylist. We are showing these examples to show that when an employee moves to a different company, the client will also move with them and the money. So when they'll be left with a smaller amount of revenue just due to the fact that, you know, everyone's gone and the original business will have nothing left. By using a non-compete agreement, companies can be at a more similar point than maybe they were before. If companies have similar revenue amounts and similar client numbers, then the companies will be at similar rates, making sure that they can both grow and have the company expand and flourish. Non-compete clauses have advantages and disadvantages. Some businesses would love a non-compete clause, and the employees would love it too, just for the annual pay and the compensation that they will receive. Other businesses would not like a non-compete clause, or maybe for the reason that they have too many employees, or they just have enough money, and would rather avoid the competition altogether. And this would lead to greater success with the position.
Thank you for listening to our presentation today. We hope you were able to learn something that you may not have known in advance. One thing that I learned is, like all things in life, non-compete agreements have their pros and cons. We will now take questions.